Our opening song is number 520, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee.
Afternoon. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us call to mind our sin and prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
To God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you.
Spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality, rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone without the water be baptized, seeing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Revealed to the nations his saving power, his saving power. Sing to the salvation joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise. The Lord has revealed to the nations His saving power, His saving power.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent His only Son into the world so that we might have life through Him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that He has loved us and sent His Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said to His disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in His love. I've told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment: love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I've called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, He may give you. This I command you: love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good afternoon. This weekend is Orthodox Easter. So you have Orthodox friends celebrating Easter this weekend. And I was watching online today, in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre in Jerusalem, the church that is housed within it, Golgotha and Calvary, where he was buried and where he was crucified and where he was buried is all within this church, the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. Has anybody ever been there? You ever been to Jerusalem and see that? Okay. You should sometime in your life get there and see that. It's a remarkable building. It's like this massive edifice of just network of ancient buildings that house the tomb and the mountain or the hill where he was buried. Brandon, where he died. So it's all within this building of this church. Anyways, every Holy Saturday before Orthodox Easter, since like the second century, it's recorded, there's this the celebration of the divine light. And so supposedly what happens is fire, like at Pentecost, comes down into the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. And it's an unconsuming fire, so it'll burn these candles and these torches, but it won't burn anything else. And this record of this going back to like the year 136, and every year since then, it's happened. But now there's cameras, and you watch it, and I mean, it's not coming down from the sky, but nonetheless, like there is fire coming out from the tomb. And it is utter chaos. Part of the beauty of that church is that it is always chaotic. It's broken up into, I think it's like 27 different parcels of land. So 27 different Orthodox or Eastern Christians or Western Christian churches control like a parcel of land. So like this is the Roman land. This is the Greek parcel. That's the Ukrainian parcel. And like, and they're militant about it. Like, don't step on my floor or else I'll like go nuts on you. It's crazy in there all the time. If you tour it, you have to walk like zigzags. You don't walk on other people's floor. It's insane. It's always chaotic. If you were to Google Church of the Holy Sepulchre ladder. Holy Sepulchre ladder. Outside of the church, there's a window. Like in the 1880s, some Orthodox priest, some dude, was washing a window. And someone said, it's not the Greek day, it's the Arminian day to wash the windows. They had a fight. Dude got off his ladder and walked inside. That ladder is still there. It hasn't moved since the 1880s. No one can agree whose job it is to take in the ladder. It is absurdity. It's utter chaos at this place where Christ died and rose. The holy place on earth, it's utter madness. But it's amazing and it's fun. So if you ever get there, you gotta experience the madness of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. So again, I say all that because it really is the holiest place for all Christians, is that church. But it's utter madness in how divided and chaotic it is. And there's always fighting and priests are like brawling in that building. It's all the time happening. Google it, YouTube it, it's everywhere online. Just how dysfunctional man has taken this sacred place and made it into. I think of that today because all of our readings, in a beautiful, integrated way, talk about the opposite of that, God's love, and how love is anything but utter chaos or a 140-year debate over whose ladder it is. It's anything but that. And we see in that first reading, Peter is going to Cornelius. Cornelius is a Gentile. He's a Roman. And he doesn't believe. He doesn't practice. He doesn't stay on his part of the floor. He's doing his own thing. But Peter brings him, though, this gospel. And this gospel is no longer just for the Jews or those who stay on the floor and don't walk on my floor, or those who take off the ladder or wash windows on Tuesdays. It is for everybody. And for the first time, these Jewish people are leaving the parameters of their square footage and going into the world to bring this gospel, not because they have to, not because they're demanded to, not because they don't get paid if they don't do it. They do it because they share in the love of the Father for all the Father's children. They participate in the love of Christ, this love that drove him to the cross and to hell and to the resurrection. And this Thursday, the ascension, they participate in that love. And that love isn't about finding ways to create more division, more chaos, more debate, more wings of a party or wings of a church. It goes forth to create this utter and radical unity that clearly man can't create, only God can do. Man in the holiest place on earth creates madness and chaos and fights over ladders. That's how strong we are. And we rely upon the love of God to supersede all of that, transcend all of that, because only He and His love and His Spirit and His desire can ever bring forth the gospel, but also create a family of the baptized, can ever begin to coordinate the unity of the body. You and I, left to ourselves, can't operate as the body, but you and I operating and living within the love of God, that can sound so often like a cliche, but it should be revolutionary. Only in living in that love can we ever be the body. Can we ever bring hope to those in darkness? Bring fire from heaven to those wandering who feel hopeless and lost and abandoned or hurt or wounded? That's the only way that can happen. So may you and I, in these final days of the Easter season, remind ourselves that left to ourselves and our own creativity and ingenuity, think of the Holy Sepulchre. That's the gold standard, and it's pretty lame. But with the love of God, we can convert pagans and sinners, Cornelius's and Saul's and the Paul's and Peter's who deny our Lord three times and everyone in between. Everything is truly possible only if we submit to His love and allow His love to be that thing which we crave and desire and hunger the most. May we totally, totally empty ourselves and disappear, and let that love triumph, not our pride, not our ingenuity or creativity, but simply that love. And when it happens, we put ladders away, but when it happens, we spread that gospel and we save souls, we populate heaven and bring the gospel to every heart so that all might know the uncreated light of grace, a fire of love that wants to roar in each and every one of our hearts. May that be our reality today and all days of our life. Love you.
Let us stand now and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Present now our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
That the Church will stand before the world without stain or blemish, holy and obedient to God's word. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That divisions in the world will be healed, violence will cease, and the peace of God's kingdom will bless the earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families and young people, especially those who are preparing to graduate, that the Lord will bless them and guide them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will strengthen the Eucharistic fervor of our parish. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of those in the military, and for police officers, firefighters, and all first responders, may they be protected by the intercession of St. Michael the Archangel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may be comforted and healed, and that those who have died may share the joys of heaven. We pray especially for John Bresnan, for whom this Mass is offered, and for Dale Dick and Vincent Tafani, who died this week. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please pause now and add your own personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord. Heavenly God, we come before you this day with faith, knowing you hear and answer all prayers according to your will. May we never allow our inclination towards brokenness and pettiness to ever rob us or others of the grace and the peace and the joy and the beauty of the love that you have for us. May that love define all that we are, all that we do. May it be the energy, the life, the essence of this mystical body we call the Church, so that together as the body, rooted in Christ and love of the Father, we may go forth into all the world, proclaiming the good news, bringing salvation to all souls, so one day all of us, after laboring and loving well here, may be together forever in the home of our Heavenly Father. And we ask all of these things confidently through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our song for the preparation of gifts is 504, I Have Loved You.
I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice and the praise for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and all of His holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with these offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always, at all times, to claim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sin of the world. By dying he destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalting your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts, sing the unending hymn of your praise without end, we acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. We
As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Lawrence our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, Michael, Margaret, and all the saints, who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, to wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Lord, the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed is called the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Amen.
Our communion song is number 821, Life-Giving Bread, Saving Cup.
Thanksgiving, O God. we give us a share in your life. You strengthen our body and our spirit. All praise to you until the end of time. Life-giving bread, saving cup, we offer in thanksgiving, O God. Life-giving bread, saving cup, we offer as a sign of our love. Remember your church which sings your praise, perfect in its truth and its love, and gather your people all together. I'll praise you until the end of time. Life-giving bread, saving cup, we offer in thanksgiving, O God. Life-giving bread, saving cup, we offer as the sign of our
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Reminder that Thursday is Ascension Thursday, so there'll be Mass. Let's see here, 6:30 at St. Margaret's on Wednesday night, and then 9 a.m. here Thursday morning for the Ascension. So 6:30 St. Margaret's on Wednesday, 9 a.m. here. See you there. That rhymes. So have a great week. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is number 519, Holy God, We Praise Thy Name.